Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and it's time for another Argena layout. So today I have my moleskin ready and I will be using some products from an Italian company that's called Stamperia. This is a great company for all my European friends who don't like to order online from the US. So this is a nice tissue paper and I love the crackle texture on it. These are some butterfly stamps, also from the same company, and some stencils. So I will be starting out with this tissue paper. You have probably seen me using Tim Holtz paper before, but you can use almost any decoupage paper. Actually, this is meant for decoupage. And by using decoupage paper or a tissue paper, you can create quick and easy backgrounds. So I'm using my scissors to cut out roughly the amount of tissue paper that I need, and I will be sticking it down using my matte medium. Now, this is by Prima, the one that I'm using, and I am applying it with a foam brush. I am going to stick down the tissue paper, and I'm using my bone folder to make it nice and smooth without any wrinkles. I am also going to make sure that I cover up all the tissue paper with matte gel. So that's what I'm doing here, and I will be doing this exact same process on the other page. Once this is dry, I will be using my scissors to cut out all the tissue paper that sticks out. So here is the final result, and you can see how quick and easy I get this crackle texture without even applying any crackle paint. For coloring my background today, I will be using these paints. These are acrylic paints and they are very fluid. These are the mixed media collection by DecoArt. So first of all, I am using a yellow one, which I am going to apply with my blending tool. I am applying some yellow in some areas of my background and I am making sure that I don't cover up the whole background. And now with a light green, I am going to fill in the gaps. As I am adding paint, notice that I only add just a little bit every time since I don't want to waste my paint. I am only applying a thin layer of paint since I don't want to lose the crackle effect of my tissue paper. As always, I have a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below the video in the details area if you are watching on YouTube, as well as on my blog. So you will find all the names of the colors as well as all the stamps and everything that I'm using today. Now I am going back with the yellow again and adding just a little bit more to make it even more lighter, and as you can see, I'm working outside of my comfort zone. I usually like to make backgrounds in browns, oranges, or blues, so I decided to make something in the cooler and brighter tones today. So I am using this violet paint, which is also by DecoArt, the mixed media fluid acrylics, and I am applying just a little bit all around the edges to frame my layout. And now it's time to do some stenciling. I am using this stencil by Stamperia, and you will find a link to this stencil just below the video in the details area. And I am using a spatula, and with my white embossing paste I am going to add some texture in my layout. Notice how I mainly stay at the edges, since I am not sure where all my elements are going to go. You will see that when I finish my layout, I will come back and just add a bit of embossing paste again, just to fill in the gaps. The embossing paste that I am using is nice and thick, and you always get perfect results. So I'm also using my spatula to wipe off any areas that I don't like. And once I am happy with my background, I am going to do some splashes. I am using gesso, this is by Faber-Castell, and I will add a little bit of water to make it more runny. So with a small brush, I am going to add some splashes. The smaller the brush, the smaller the splashes. The bigger the brush, you get bigger splashes. I think that adding those splashes here and there is going to bind all the white texture paste with my main background. And here is the final result. You can see the texture from the tissue paper, as well as all the dimensions that the texture paste adds to the background. So now I am going to go ahead and stamp a part of this stamp. I want only the stems. So I have used my big brush marker directly on the stamp, and now I have a rough idea of where these stems are. And now I am going to create a flower pot. I'm using my pencil to draw the flower pot on a Manila cardstock by Ranger. And once I'm happy with my sketch, I will be using my scissors to cut it out. I am also going to stamp the flowers, and I'm using black archival ink. And now I can go ahead and use my fluid acrylic by DecoArt to color the pot as well as the flowers. For my flower pot, I will be using this color, the violet one. It's exactly the same one that I've used for the edges of my layout, and this kind of brings everything together. I am using a violet big brush marker to add some shading on the edges, and I will be using a darker one. And here is how I store my markers. I keep them in a IKEA box, which is nice and transparent, so I can see all the colors, and I like to lay them down, so I store them vertically. I am using my favorite brown marker to add the shading at the edges, as well as wherever I feel it needs shading. And notice how I didn't bother to cover up my area with gel medium, which is something I always do when I plan to use these markers. However, just because I had acrylic paint on this flower pot, it actually makes the surface non-porous. I will go ahead and use my acrylic paints and color the flowers. I am using three colors, white, yellow and orange. I am going to color all the flowers white, but I am making sure that I apply a thin layer so I don't lose the stamped lines. As I apply yellow, I like to have brush strokes, so I'm not actually blending the yellow with the white. I just love this artsy look, and then I will finish off the flowers by adding just a little bit of yellow at the base of each petal. When I finished coloring all the flowers, I used my scissors to cut them out. I am adding some shadows on the stems by using my big brush marker, so I am going all over the stems and blending them out with my fingers. And now I am going to add some shading for the flowers. Although I usually stick my images down and then do the shading, I decided to do the shading first just because I have a white flower and I don't want to turn it brown. The brown shading will actually help the flowers to pop up. If you notice, I do have yellow flowers with white, and my background is always very light with yellow tones and light greens. But you see that the flowers do not get lost on the background. I will finish adding my shading, and then I am going to stick everything down with gel medium. I always like to use a thin black marker to go around the elements that I stick down, and this actually helps my elements to pop out of the page. The one that I'm using now is the small tip black marker by Faber-Castell, and I am going to add some details on the stems as well as all over the flowers. I am actually following the lines that are stamped and I can still see under the paint. Notice how I'm not trying to get a perfect line, more like a sketchy one. And also, here is a tip, make sure that all the gel medium is nice and dry before you touch your layout with your brushes, because you will ruin them if it's still wet. Remember that gel medium is a glue, and if the tip of your marker touches the glue, it will ruin them forever. This is a pastel pencil by Faber-Castell, and it's a great alternative to add shadows. It creates nice and soft shadows that you can blend with your finger. They are available in a variety of colors, and they are a great alternative if you want to add shadows easily, especially if you don't own the big brush markers. Once I'm happy with the shadows on the petals, I am going to add just a touch of brown all around the edge of my layout. And now it's time to stamp the quote for today. Notice how I stamp one letter at a time, and I am doing that just because my art journal is quite bulky and I don't get a nice impression if I stamp the whole word at once. I am using Archival ink, which is nice and permanent, and the alphabet stamp set that I'm using is called Happy Letters by Hero Arts, which is unfortunately discontinued. Now that I have all the sentiment down, I am trying to decide which of the butterflies I am going to stick and where. And once I have decided where my butterfly is going to go, first I am using my white gel pen and add some highlights on the letters. I am also going to add some highlights on the petals as well as the flower pot and the stems. And the finishing touch is going to be my butterfly. So first of all, I am going to cover up a scrap paper with the violet. This is the same color that I've used on the pot. And once this is nice and dry, I am going to use Archival ink to stamp on top my butterfly. I will use my scissors to cut it out and then stick it with gel medium all on my layout. I am stamping the butterfly with Archival ink so that I can have the details of the butterfly body and the antennas, which I didn't bother to cut out. And now with my gel medium, I'm going to place it down. Now notice how by adding the violet butterfly, I'm bringing some of that color on the other page. And that kind of brings everything together. And you can see that the technique is pretty much the same. After sticking down the butterfly, I have used my brown marker to add the shading, and then I'm going all around the edges with my black thin marker, and then of course I am going to add some highlights with my gel pen. And this is where I feel that I have a gap, so I am going back with my stencil and my embossing paste, and I'm just going to add a little bit of embossing paste there to add some texture and interest, so I cover up that gap. I am also going to add some stenciling at the edges, as well as just a little bit on top of the flower pot. And that was the layout for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Thank you all for watching. If you want more inspiration, you can click any of these images on the screen, and if you are watching from a mobile device, then you can find all the links to these videos just below the video in the details area. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already, because this is a way to let me know that you like my videos and I can keep up posting even more ideas.